Theta is equal to 90. The angle of intersection between the two lines is 90 degree, where A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2 are the direction ratios of the line 1 and 2. To be perpendicular to each other is A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is equal to 0. Hello dear students, welcome to this session of mathematics class. I am Mr. Niranjan, Faculty of Mathematics, Vidyashram PU College, the Temple of Excellence. Now, in my previous class, we have discussed regarding the equation of line. So, the derivation of equation of line passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector, and equation of a line passing through two points both in vector and Cartesian form, and the problems based on that. Now, in this session, I am going to discuss regarding the angle of intersection between the two lines. This is a very important concept. Now, today I am going to discuss regarding the angle of intersection between the two lines and the problems based on angle of intersection between the two lines. Now, suppose if P is a point on the line L1 and Q is a point on the line L2. So, if P and Q are the points on the line L1 and L2, so if P1 is a point on the line L1 and Q is a point on the line L2, so therefore the direction ratios for the line L1 is A1, B1, C1, and for the line L2 it is A2, B2, C2. So, A1, B1, C1 are the direction ratios for the line L1 and A2, B2, C2 are the direction ratios for the line L2. Let P and Q be any points on the line L1 and L2. So, if theta is the angle between, if theta is an acute angle between the two lines OP and OQ. So, if this theta is an angle between the lines OP and OQ, vector with components A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2 respectively. Therefore, the position vector of P is denoted as vector OP is equal to A1i plus B1j plus C1k. Similarly, the position vector of OQ is equal to A2i plus B2j plus C2k cap, A and B. So, therefore, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are the components of the vectors OP and OQ. Therefore, vector OP and OQ can be denoted as A1i plus B1j plus C1k and A2i plus B2j plus C2k. Now, if theta is the angle between, then the angle between the lines is given by cos theta is equal to mod of A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root of A2 square plus B2 square. So, you might have been studied this in your vectors. The angle of intersection between the vectors is given by vector A dot B divided by length of A into length of B. The same concept we are using here. So, the angle of intersection between these two vectors are given by, so that is, since the components of OP is equal to A1i plus B1j plus C1k. Similarly, the components of OQ are, that is, vector A2i plus B2j plus C2k. Therefore, the cosine of angle between them is given by cos theta is equal to OP dot OQ vector divided by length of vector OP into length of vector OQ under mod. So, this is nothing but, this is equal to A1, A2. Therefore, cos theta is equal to modulus of A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 divided by length of OP is nothing but square root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square under mod. So, that is what we have written here. So, this is cos theta. The angle of intersection between the lines P and Q, L1 and L2 is given by cos theta is equal to modulus of A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by length root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. That is, specifically, that is nothing but A dot B divided by length of A into length of B, or it is also equal to OP dot OQ divided by length of OP and OQ vectors. So, that is the angle of intersection between the two vectors. So, in general, the angle of intersection between the two lines L1 and L2 whose components are a1, b1, c1 and a2, b2, c2 are is given by cos theta is equal to modulus of a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by square root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. Now, let us know regarding the parallel condition and perpendicular condition of these two lines. Now, let us come to the first condition. If two lines L1 and L2 with direction ratios A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2. So, if L1 and L2 are the two lines, L1 and L2 are the two lines with the direction ratios A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2 are the direction ratios for L1 and L2. Suppose if theta is equal to 90 degrees, if theta is equal to 90, then what is this cos theta? Cos theta is nothing but cos 90. Cos 90 is nothing but 0. Then what happens this angle of intersection between the two lines, that is cos theta is equal to, this is 0 is equal to cos theta is equal to, what is the formula we have? A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square under mod. So, if this is equal to 0 and the numerator divided by the denominator, if you cross multiply, so you will get this numerator A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. So, here if theta is equal to 90 degree, you will get cos 90 is equal to 0. Since cos theta is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by length root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square under mod. So, this entire quantity, this is nothing but 0 into this. If we cross multiply, so what happens? This becomes 0. That is what I have written here. The denominator will become, denominator cross multiply will become reduces to 0. So, therefore, then what we will get, the numerator is equal to 0. The numerator is equal to 0 means A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal. So, hence the condition for the two lines to be perpendicular to each other is A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. A dot B is equal to 0. If A dot B A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0 means then the two lines L1 and L2 are perpendicular to each other. Suppose if theta is equal to 0 degree, then cos theta is equal to 0. Cos theta is equal to 0 means cos 0. What is cos 0? Sin 0 is 0. Cos 0 is 1. So, then this reduces to 1 is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. So, after simplification, this reduces to a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So, hence the condition for the two lines to be parallel to each other is the ratio or proportional A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So, the very important concept here is the angle of intersection between the two lines is given by cos theta is equal to modulus of A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. If the two lines are perpendicular to each other, then the condition for the two lines to be perpendicular to each other is A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. Hence, the condition for the two lines to be parallel to each other is the ratios are proportional, that is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. Hence, the condition for the two lines to be perpendicular to each other is A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. Hence, the condition for the two lines to be parallel to each other is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. Suppose, if the angle between the two lines when their equations are in the form of a vector. So, if theta is an acute angle between the lines, if the lines are in the form of a vector equation, R is equal to A1 plus lambda into B1 and R is equal to A2 plus mu into B2, then the angle of intersection between these two lines is given by cos theta is equal to B1 dot B2 divided by length of B1 and B2. So, if the equations of the lines, if the lines are represented in the form of a equation of a line, R is equal to A1 plus lambda into B1 plus R is also equal to A2 into mu b2, then the angle of intersection cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 into length of b2 mod. So these are the general equation of a line. The equation of a line passing through a given point and parallel to the given vector. So then the angle between such lines are given by b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 and b2 under mod. Okay. So in Cartesian form, if theta is the angle between the two lines, if the equations are in the form of a Cartesian form, in the vector form, cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 and b2. If the equations of the lines are in the Cartesian form, x minus x1 by a1 is equal to y minus y1 by b1 is equal to z minus z1 by c1, equation number 1. And second equation, x minus x2 by a2, y minus y2 by b2, and z minus z2 by c2. So if the two lines are in the form of a Cartesian form, if the equations of the lines are in the Cartesian form, then the angle between them is given by where a1, b1, c1 and a2, b2, c2 are the direction ratios of the lines 1 and 2 respectively. Then the angle of intersection between them is given by cos theta is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. This is same as that of the previous one. So if the equations of the lines are represented in the Cartesian form, then the angle of intersection between such lines is given by cos theta is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square under mod, where a1, b1, c1 and a2, b2, c2 are the direction ratios of the line 1 and 2. So these are the concept regarding the angle of intersection between the two lines. Now let us take few problems based on this parallel perpendicular condition and how to find the angle of intersection between the two lines. So usually you will get one question from this for 3 months. Now let us come to an example one. Example problem number one, example for 3 months. Find the angle between the pair of lines given by vector r is equal to 3i plus 2j minus 4k plus lambda into I plus 2j plus 2k and vector r is equal to 5i minus 2j plus mu into 3i plus 2j plus 6k. These are the two lines given. So here, now let us represent comparing with vector r is equal to a1 plus lambda into b1 vector. So we will get vector a1 is equal to 3i plus 2j minus 4k and vector b1 is equal to I plus 2j plus 2k cap. Similarly, if you compare this with vector r is equal to a2 plus mu into vector b2, here vector a2 is equal to 5i minus 2j and vector b2 is equal to 3i plus 2j plus 6k. That's it. Okay, if the lines are represented, if theta is an acute angle between the lines a1, r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, r is equal to a2 plus mu into b2, then the angle of intersection between them is given by cos theta is equal to mod of b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 and b2. So here, since the given equations are in the vector form, the standard equation of a line in the vector form, r is equal to a plus lambda into b vector. So therefore the angle of intersection between them is given by angle between the vectors b1 and b2 is given by vector b1 b2 is given by cos theta is equal to mod of vector b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 into length of b2 vector. Now find out the value of b1 dot b2. Now b1 vector dot b2 is equal to, what is b1? This is b1 vector and this is b2 vector. Now the dot product of these two, 1 into 3 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 6. So this is equal to 3 plus 4 plus 2 6 are 12. So this is equal to 12 plus 4 is 16, 16 plus 3 is 19. This is equal to 19. Now find out the magnitude of B1. Length of B1 is equal to root of 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square. 1 square is 1 plus 2 square is 4 plus 4. This is root 9. Square root of 9 is 3. Similarly, length of vector B2 is equal to root of 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square. 3 square is 9 plus 2 square is 4 plus 6 square is 36. So this is equal to square of 36 plus 4 is 40 plus 9 is 49. Square root of 49 is 7. Now therefore the angle between them is given by, so therefore the angle between the lines is given by angle between two lines is cos theta is equal to, cos theta is equal to mod of b1 dot b2. What is b1 b2 dot product? 19 divided by 3 into 7. That is equal to, therefore cos theta is equal to 19 divided by 21. So therefore theta is equal to cos inverse of 19 divided by 21. This is the angle of intersection between the two given lines. Theta is equal to cos inverse 19 by 27. That's it. So if you do this much, you will get 3 marks. So definitely we'll expect angle of intersection between the two vectors or between the two lines, either in vector chapter or in 3D chapter. Hope you followed this. Now let us come to the next problem, same type problem. Now let us take a similar problem. Find the angle between that pair of lines given by r is equal to 2i minus 5j plus k cap plus lambda into 3i plus 2j plus 6k cap, and r is equal to 7i minus 6j plus mu into I plus 2j plus 2k cap. Now here also, since this is in the form vector r is equal to a1 plus lambda into b1, vector r is equal to a2 plus mu into vector b2. So these two equations, so now what is required to find? Whenever the equations of the lines are in the vector form, then the angle between them is given by cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 and b2. Now just find out the value of b1. What is b1 from this? B1 is equal to vector 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 6k cap. And what is b2 from that equation number 2? From the second line, b2 is equal to I plus 2j plus 2k cap. I plus 2j plus 2k cap. Now what is the formula for the angle of intersection between the line? Angle between the two lines is cos theta is equal to vector b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 into length of vector b2 mod. Now find out b1 dot b2. So the angle between the two lines, whenever the equations of the lines are in the vector form, is given by cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 vector divided by length of vector b1 into length of vector b2. Now find out the value of b1 dot b2. B1 dot b2 is equal to the dot product of these two. So 3 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 6 into 2. 3 plus 4 plus 6 2 is 12. So this is again 12 plus 4 16. 16 plus 3 is 19 divided by length of b and length of b1 is equal to root of 3 square is 9 plus 2 square is 4 plus 6 square is 36. So this is equal to 36 plus 4 plus 9 is 49. Square of 49 is 7. Similarly, length of vector b2 is equal to, so 1 square is 1 plus 4 plus 4. This is equal to root 9. That is equal to 3. This is same as that of the previous problem. So therefore, cos theta is equal to a dot b, length of b1 dot b2 is 19 divided by length of b1 and length of b2 is 7 into 3. So this is equal to 19 by, so therefore cos theta is equal to 19 divided by 21, same as that of the previous problem. 19 divided by
21.
Hope you followed this. Now, let us come to the next problem. Find the angle between the pair of lines given by R is equal to 3i cap plus j cap minus 2k cap plus lambda into I cap minus j cap minus 2k cap and R is equal to 2i cap minus j cap minus 56k cap plus mu into 3i minus 5j cap minus 4k cap. Same, this is same as that of the previous problem. Now you can comparing with vector R is equal to vector a1 plus lambda into b1. So therefore vector b1 is equal to, this is b1, I minus j cap minus 2k cap. Similarly, this is vector R is equal to a2 plus lambda into b2. What is required is vector b2 is equal to 3i cap minus 5j cap minus 4k cap. Now, therefore, the angle between the lines, angle between two lines is cos theta is equal to, cos theta is equal to magnitude of mod of b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 into length of b2. Okay, now find out the value of b1 dot b2. Now b1 dot b2 is equal to the dot product of these two vectors, 1 into 3 plus minus 1 into minus 5 plus minus 2 into minus 4. This is equal to 3 ones are 3, minus into minus plus 5, minus into minus plus 4, 2s are 8. So this is equal to 8 plus 8, 16. See here, b1 dot b2 is equal to 1 into 3 is 3, minus 1 into minus 5 is plus 5, minus 2 into minus 4 is plus 8. So 8 plus 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 8 is 16. Now similarly, find out the magnitude of a vector b1. Vector b1 magnitude is 1 square plus minus 1 square plus minus 2 square. 1 square is 1, minus 1 square is also 1, plus minus 2 square is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6. Similarly, magnitude of vector b2 is equal to root of this 3 square is 9 plus 5 square, minus 5 square is 25 plus minus 4 square is 16. This is 9 plus 16 is 25 plus 25 is 50. 50 can also be written as, this is 5 root 2. 25 into 2, that is nothing but 5 root 2. So the angle of intersection between the lines is given by cos theta is equal to mod of b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 and b2 can be written as b1 dot b2 is equal to 16 divided by length of b1 is root 6 into, this is 5 times root 2. Okay, now this can also be written as 16 divided by 5 into root 6. Root 6 can also be written as root 6 is equal to root 2 into root 3. So this is root 3 into root 2 into root 2 is root 2 whole square. Square square root gets cancelled. It is equal to 16 divided by 5 into root 3 into 2. This 2 8s are gets cancelled. This is equal to 8 divided by 5 root 3. So therefore, the angle of intersection between them is given by cos theta is equal to 8 divided by 5 times root 3. 8 by 5 root 3 is the angle of intersection between the given two lines. That's it. Hope you followed. Okay. Now let us come to the next problem. What is the next problem? Find the angle between the pair of lines. So the equations of the lines are in the form of a Cartesian equation. So, find the angle between the pair of lines x plus 3 by 3 is equal to y minus 1 by 5 is equal to z plus 3 by 4 and x plus 1 by 1 is equal to y minus 4 by 1 is equal to z minus 5 divided by 1. Just now itself, I explained whenever the equations of the lines are in the Cartesian form, then the angle of intersection whenever the equations of the lines are in the Cartesian form is given by. So, if the in Cartesian form, if theta is the angle between the lines, then the angle between the lines is given by cos theta is equal to mod of a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square, where a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2 are the direction ratios. These values are to be considered, a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2. Now come to the given problem. So here this is to be considered, this is a1 b1 c1 and a2 b2 c2. So therefore the direction ratios are, the direction ratios of two lines are here a1, b1, c1 is equal to 3, 5, 4 and a2, b2, c2 is equal to 1, 1, 2. So the direction ratios are to be considered. Now therefore the angle between the lines is given by angle between the two lines is cos theta is equal to modulus of a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by the square root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. That's it. So if the equations of the lines are in the Cartesian form, then the cos theta is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square under mod. If the equations of the lines are in the vector form, then cos theta is equal to vector b1 dot b2 divided by length of b1 into length of b2 under mod. Now let us find out this. That's it. Now I'll write here, therefore cos theta is equal to modulus of a1 a2, 3 into 1 plus 5 into 1 plus 4 into 2 divided by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square, 3 square 9 plus 5 square is 25 plus 4 square is 60 into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus 1 square is 1 plus 1 plus 4. So I will write here, therefore cos theta is equal to mod of 3 ones are 3 plus 5 ones are 5 plus 4 twos are 8 divided by, so this is 25 plus 25 root 50 into root of 4 plus 1 5 plus 1 is 6. So this is equal to 8 plus 8 16 divided by 50 can be written as 5 root 2 and 6 can be written as root 2 into root 3. So therefore this is same as that as the previous problem, previous answer will get 16 divided by 5 root 3 into root 2 into root 2 is root 2 whole square is 2, 2 8s gets cancelled. So therefore cos theta is equal to mod of 8 divided by 5 times root 3. This is the simplified answer. So therefore cos theta is equal to, you can remove mod 8 by 5 root 3 is the simplified answer. So cos theta is equal to 8 by 5 root 3 is the simplified answer for this also. Okay, hope you followed. Now let us come to the next problem. So find the value of P so that the lines 1 minus x by 3 is equal to 7y minus 14 by 2p is equal to z minus 3 by 2 and 7 minus 7x by 3p is equal to y minus 5 by 1 is equal to 6 minus z by 5 are at right angles. Now here, since the given equations are again in the Cartesian form, let us convert this into the standard form. The given equation can be written as, that is 1 minus x by 3 is equal to 7y minus 14 divided by 2p is equal to z minus 3 by 2. So this is no need to change. Let us change this. 1 minus x can also be written as minus x plus 1 or you can take minus out, this becomes x minus 1. So this is x minus 1 divided by minus 3. So transfer that minus to the denominator. X minus 1 by minus 3 is equal to here. Now this 7y minus 14, for this 7y minus 14, let us divide by 7. Then what you will get? Y minus 14 by 7 is equal to 2 divided by, this is nothing but 2p divided by 7. So that is y minus 2 divided by 2p by 7 is equal to z minus 3 by 2. This is the standard form for the equation number 1. Okay, right. Now see here, I'll explain once again. The given equation 1 minus x by 3 is equal to 7y minus 14 by 2p is equal to z minus 3 by 2. Convert this into the standard form. Now 1 minus x can also be written as minus x plus 1, or you can take minus out x minus 1. So x minus minus of x minus 1 by 3 can be written as x minus 1 divided by minus 3, and divide by 14, then what you will get, sorry, divide by 7. What you will get? 7, 7 gets cancelled. Y minus 14 by 7 is 2 divided by 2p by 7, and this z minus 3 by 2 as it is. Now, on the other hand, second equation, 7 minus 7x divided by 3p is equal to y minus 5 by 1 is equal to 6 minus z divided by 5. Now, let us convert this. 7 minus 7x, let us write minus 7x plus 7. This can be written as 7 minus 7x can be written as minus 7x plus 7. You can take minus 7 out. If minus 7 is taken out, then this can be written as x. Minus into plus, it is minus 1. So this can be written as x minus 1 divided by 3p by 7 along with negative sign is equal to, this is same, y minus 5 by 1. Again, this 6 minus z, 6 minus z can also be written as minus z plus 6, or you can take minus out. So then this can be written as z minus 6 divided by minus 1. Okay, this is the standard form, right? Now therefore, this is nothing but a1, b1, c1, and this is a2, b2, c2. What is the condition given? So the two lines are at right angle. So the two lines are at right angle means a1, a2 plus b1, b2 plus c1, c2 is equal to 0. That's all. I will rub this and I will do here. This is minus 3 comma 2p by 7 comma 2. Okay. Now the given condition is they are at right angle, a1, a2 plus b1, b2 plus c1, c2 is equal to 0. Now substitute, this is a1, a2, a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2. So that is minus 3 into minus 3p by 7 plus 2p by 7 into 1 plus 2 into minus 5 is equal to 0. This is the given condition. That's it. See here. So the given condition is a1, a2 plus b1, b2 plus c1, c2 is equal to 0 because the two lines are at the right angles. I'll solve here. So what is this equal to? That is minus into minus 3, 3 is a 9p divided by 7 plus 2p into 1 is 2p by 7 plus 5 plus into minus minus 5, 2 is a 10 is equal to 0. Plus into minus minus, that is 9p by 7 plus 2p by 7 plus into minus minus 10 is equal to 0. You can take LCM. 7 is the LCM. This is 9p plus 2p minus 7 into 10 is 70 is equal to 0. Minus 70. Cross multiply it. This is 2p plus 9, 2p plus 9p is 11p minus 70 is equal to 0 into 7 is 0. 11p is equal to 70. Therefore, p is equal to 70 divided by 11. So the value of p is equal to 70 divided by 11 is the value. So at P is equal to 70 by 11, the two lines are at right angles. That's all. This is the problem. That's it. So that is regarding the given problem. So the required answer is 70 by 11. Just find out A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 by converting the given equation to the standard form. Since the given condition is A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is equal to 0, substitute, you will get the answer. That's it. So hope you followed this. Okay. Now that's all for today's session. Let us meet with a different concept in the next session. Thank you. Thank you very much.